Welcome to the OpenMW-CS video of this release. While we still lack developers working on our editor, we managed to include a handful, or rather four handfuls, of bug fixes and features in version 0.45.0. Well, constant dripping wears away the stone. Though, admittedly, OpenMW-CS is quite a big one. Anyway, let's concentrate on the progress made and go through the recent changes. OpenMW-CS provides a color picker widget to easily select the color of your choice. However, we somehow missed one property, namely the color of light sources, which still showed a rather ugly integer representation of the selected color. The current release fixes that issue. In the original engine, internal lists for magic effects, weapon types, blood types, etc. are consecutively numbered, which means that they are generally not in alphabetical order. As OpenMW adopts most of these lists to ensure correct loading of content files, previous versions simply displayed those lists as they were, hence not alphabetically sorted. We have now rewritten the corresponding code to automatically display such lists in alphabetical order, which drastically increases usability. The current release further extends the already existing search and verify functionality of our editor. First of all, OpenMW-CS is now able to perform a case-sensitive global search. You only need to activate that option in the search form itself. Also note that our editor now displays the number of search results which remain in the list. Secondly, we have completely overhauled the existing verifier messages by updating the underlying code, adding some missing checks, and making the text descriptions more consistent. On top of that, enchantment records are now checked by the verifier too. Last but not least, OpenMW-CS now provides the option to ignore base records in verifier runs. Tired of the countless error and warning messages caused by loading Morrowind and its two expansions? Just check that option and concentrate on debugging your own work. Our last release included a new set of editor icons. So far so good, but many of us had a remote feeling that something was off. Soon we realized what was going on and took radical measures. OpenMW-CS now displays icons for all menu items. And while we were at it, context menus got icons too. A small yet powerful change, if you ask me. Version 0.45.0 also includes two changes regarding the scene view. On the one hand, our editor now uses the dedicated markers for light sources and leveled creature lists. I had to wait long enough for those ninja monkeys to reappear. Or were they just hiding? On the other hand, this release introduces NPC and creature rendering in OpenMW-CS. Yes, you are finally able to appreciate Morrowind's truly sophisticated character models in our editor. Don't get me wrong, I quite like those models. Anyway, this feature should definitely help with character placement and general scene setup. Please note that the current implementation ignores animations and does not render weapons. Nevertheless, this is an essential feature on our way to version 1.0. That's all for now. If you haven't already watched the engine video for this release, now is your chance. If you have watched it, watch it a second time. In any case, check out the official release notes for more in-depth information and visit our homepage and forums on openmw.org for more updates. See you next time. Thanks for watching.